Hello. In this lecture, we will go over how to use the CVAT SDK. First, let's cover why you would use the SDK. If you want to create your own solution using the CVAT API, but don't want to spend the time on the details, the SDK is made for you. It's a happy medium between complexity and flexibility. The SDK includes functionality to solve most problems you'll encounter, but still allows you to build your own solutions if the situation calls for it. The CVAT SDK makes your integration code more simple and reliable, encapsulating low-level request machinery and providing additional features on top of the API. Here's how you would get started. The CVAT SDK is a Python library. It has the same open source MIT license as CVAT itself, meaning it can be used by anyone. The SDK is platform independent, which means you can use it on, for example, Windows, Mac, and Linux. The official releases are available in the standard Python package repository. To install the latest version, just run pip install cvat-sdk in the terminal. In a moment, we'll see examples, but if you want to jump straight to the documentation, follow the link at the bottom. The library functionality can be split into three key parts: the low-level API, which provides you server API wrappers; the high-level API, which allows you to interact with the server objects using the object-oriented API; and the various utilities and helpers that make using the CVAT API a little bit easier. Let's look a little closer at these parts and see how they can all be used together in a custom application. Here are some of the basics about the low-level API. Its main functionality is to act as a REST API wrapper for each server endpoint and method. It allows you to work with an object-oriented Python API instead of raw HTTP requests. While it can be relatively easy to write requests manually, these wrappers are especially useful in the long term because they allow you to be notified about server API changes by the Python interpreter automatically. To help you further, this layer takes care of details like session management, input and output validation, and type conversions. It also provides information and inline documentation to linters and to your code editor. The key component and starting point of this layer is the API client class, which we will cover next. If you want to read more about the low-level API, check out the documentation at the link below. Here's an example. First, we create an API client instance with a configuration object. In this case, we're just specifying the hostname, but we could also indicate a preferred auth method and other options. The API client class ties together all the elements of this layer and provides you simple access to all the server endpoints. Next, we make a call to the endpoint. In this example, we're making a call to the auth create login endpoint to perform a login. For this request, we would need to pass in our credentials. We'll see how to do that in the next few slides. Afterward, hopefully we have a 200 response and some data to work with. The response data is automatically parsed into a corresponding model object. There are many options on how we can alter the default behavior of the API, which are explained in the documentation. For instance, we can enable or disable data validation or response parsing. In case of request failure, we can use any style of error handling, including both exceptions and status codes. Now let's talk about the basics of the high-level API. This layer provides problem-oriented APIs, encapsulates low-level logic, and allows you to focus more on your task. For instance, it includes object-oriented wrappers for the server entities, such as tasks and projects. Similar to the low-level API, there is the central client class, which ties together most of the functionality and provides simple access to these wrappers. This layer is built on top of the low-level API. Compared to the low-level, it uses the same models but implements multi-request operations and provides more convenient high-level interfaces. We'll see an example in a moment. If you want to read more about the high-level API, check out the documentation at the link below. Here's an example where we retrieve a list of our current tasks and create a new task. First, we create a client instance, passing a custom configuration object with details like the hostname and the auth credentials. Once we're authenticated, we can ask for a list of tasks and iterate through them, creating a backup of each one. With the lower level APIs, creating a backup would be a complex operation involving multiple server requests. But with this layer, it can be done with one call of a single function. Finally, we'll create a new task and print out that new task's ID. using a high-level object providing convenient access to the object attribute. Here's another example where we create a task using the high-level API. This time, we're specifying a label and some images. Note that we use the same models from the lower API layer. As with the backup previously, the lower API layers would require much more work to create a task, but now it's simple. At the bottom, we test the resulting object to make sure its task name matches what we specified earlier, and that the number of images matches the number of resources we gave it. And here's an example where we export a task using the low-level API. Note the difference in complexity and flexibility between the API layers. Like previous examples, we create an API client instance and pass in a custom configuration object. After we are authenticated, we retrieve a task by ID. Using that task's ID, we start a loop to verify that the task has an annotation file that we can download. If we get a 202 status, that means exporting has already started, so we'll wait. But if we get a 201 response status, we know the file is available for download, so we'll start downloading it. Once we get a response status of 200, we know that the downloading has started. After the download is finished, we can write it to a zip file on our local machine. As you can see, this API layer gives you more control over the requests, but also requires more effort from you. For homework, try creating and exporting a task using the SDK. You can write your own Python script and create a task using some images you already have on your machine. Try it first with the low-level API and then with the high-level API to understand the problems the high-level API solves. And if you need some help, check out the documentation at the top of this slide. Thanks for watching.